Segment of Big Bang Theory's BTS vlog. That's right, we are back. I vlogged while we were down, but the systems are back and operating again. So let me give it time and date stamp. It is 12 hours and 38 minutes into the day of Sunday, June 12th, 2016. Yeah, so there's a bit of a backlog to catch up on. So we are back in our backlog stage, so we'll see what ends up happening in terms of our upload schedule, but I hope to sort of clear it up as soon as possible. I think we're about a week off, but these next 2 days or so we should be able to get caught up. So by the end of the week, we'll be back on schedule again, and the vlogs will only be a couple days out. It's the 10th, it's the 12th, it's the 12th now, and the last one that went up was June 4th, so we are 8 days out. There's one going up today, that will be from the 4th to the 7th, so that will that means we'll be the one going up after, one that goes up today will be out tomorrow. That will mean we'll be just 5 days behind. Tomorrow's should bring us even closer. We'll see how much we can get into tomorrow's the upload, tomorrow's episode. So, and I think Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday we should be current again. So, not too bad. There's an issue with Kubuntu. I'm going to be taking a larger look into this again. I'll be starting with a new series. If you want more details on Kubuntu, go take a look at the series that's coming out. It should be out this week, called Ubuntu BSD Unix Catal. That's our Unix show. And I think, unlike other channels that talk about Linux, we are not a dual boot environment. In other words, the only operating system we use here is Linux. We don't use anything else. Everything is done here, all the channel stuff, everything is done on Linux. So we really stress test Linux to its limits. We put it into a production environment and we tell you how it works within a production environment. So you know, okay, I'm not just simply saying, okay, this works. You're seeing it. You're seeing Linux at work. And so this is what Ubuntu BSD Unix Catal is. It takes from that position here that everything is done on Linux, and it's sort of looking around the community in terms from the perspective of open source. And this is where I have the Open Protocol Institute. I set that up to improve on open source and to bring open source to a larger variety of serving into science, into technology, to education. In other words, anywhere that the open policy, the open concept can be applied, it should be applied. And it's not a detriment to industry, because in many cases, if you really look at how things have developed in the computers and the reason why the computer industry is moving as fast as it is, a lot of it's because of open source development, because you have a lot of people developing in this environment here. And you as a producer, producing an end product, you could take from a variety of different choices. And the licensing fee, because it's open and free, is almost negligible. So you can take the package, an open source package, bring it into your facility, fix it up a bit to your specific design, custom tailor it, and away you go. In other words, If the internet and software were integrated with, as it were, integrated with the hardware, if this was the software that runs the hardware, if it was a sort of a fabric, just a plain fabric, you can be the tailor that creates the new product. In other words, you can create your own custom fit. You can create your own custom design. The open source environment simply provides a plain cloth. And then you, as a designer, take from the cloth, from the fabric manufacturers, and build from there on out. And so it provides a very nice, very accessible design environment for those who want to really sort of, you know, bring out something new. And the thing is, you can make money with this, because if you're designing something brand new that nobody else has, and because you've taken from point here and point here, there's ways of because there are ways of bringing out to the customer cheaper, because you're taking from the open source environment, which is free, and so your overhead, your cost to develop this is minimal, because you've dropped off your some of your development costs to the open source environment, and now you've brought in you bring your product out. With that, so you can pull back on some of your pricing, so because your cost, your overhead, has been reduced. So it provides an open package. It provides a better way for business, for industry to form, perform, and function, so that it can maximize its profit off of, well, not even maximize it, have a good profit off of open source, but at the same time still give back to open source and not close it off. Anyways, I'm going to leave that here for now, and I will see you in the next segment of Big Bang Theory RL. I've still got a few more things left to get done, and yay. Well, welcome back to the next segment of the BTS vlog. We're out again. Now we've got two cameras working. The editing bays are back online. And that means it's time. To get this party started. Anyways, I'm looking for the bathrooms. Let's see if they've got anything here. Well, this is recycling. Oh, I almost forgot time and date stamp. Yeah, it's 14 hours and 35 minutes into the day of I think it's Sunday, June 12, 2016. When your mind wanders, you kind of you got to try to figure out what day it is. I think this is where the bathroom is, possibly. I don't necessarily know. Looks like a house. So let me go up, follow the path up, and see where it leads us. So I'm going to take the regular path and see if that's where it goes. Toronto has developed to this point where the parks come right up to the people's homes. And, yeah. Okay. So it does look like this is where the bathrooms are. So now let's go up here and see if we can find the bathroom. One of the key considerations, if you're out having a good time, okay, Adams Park. One of the things that's important are bathrooms. Because, well, here's a splash area. You don't have bathrooms, and you've got food, well, that's a recipe for problems. Anyways, I'm going in, so afterwards. Well, it's just been a few minutes. It's still the Sunday, June 12th, 2016. Went to the bathroom, and one might be assuming, washing the hands, right? This is the question after you've gone to the bathroom. Have you washed your hands? This is particularly for guys, anyways. Most girls will wash their hands. Assuming, because girls do want to be neater than guys, they are typically cleaner. But not necessarily so.
if you know anything about virology and the spread of microbes, then you begin to understand that washing your hands after going to the bathroom may not necessarily be the best option. I'll tell you why. Particularly in a public bathroom, after the first two or three people have gone, the buildup of water and germs, in terms of the aqueous environment that causes the spread of bacteria and disease, grows. And as it grows, it doesn't matter whether you wash your hands or not, the bacteria is in the environment and your hands pick it up. So you are no cleaner entering the bathroom after you've finished going to the bathroom, no cleaner than if you would wash your hands or not. The best option is one of these things here. This is a hand sanitizer. This is the way to get clean. And if you want to know why, it's because the key ingredient here, no matter what it smells like, you know, smells nicer or whatever, you're talking about the use of methyl alcohol. Methyl alcohol, or any alcohol for matter, is a killer to most diseases, bacteria, microbes, and so on and so forth. Why? Well, if you understand genetics, you understand the processing of anything in organic chemistry, you understand that alcohol is a very strong solvent, an organic acid. And it cleans the surface because it ends up destroying the cells. And we've got a little animal in here. Let's see what we got. It's gone away. Anyway, we had a nice option for woods here, but doesn't seem to be showing anything. Anyway, as I say, alcohol is your primary sanitizer. Here's some more flowers. These are really nice flowers here. And these are more developed. Before, the ones that we were showing before, they weren't that developed. The vines weren't that developed. So these are a deeper woods. They've sort of left sections of Toronto as expanded. We're actually outside. We're in the so-called the GTA, the Greater Toronto Area. And this kind of gives an idea of how Toronto has spread. It's gone from just Toronto and suburbs to GTA, the Greater Toronto Area. This is where we are now. And yeah, so we have all that. It's a nice environment to sort of walk around in. And then I've got the same thing at my place too. We've got the woods to walk behind. Well, the sort of the industrial area, and it's heavily wooded. So anyways, we're back at the campground. We're having a church picnic, and I'll see you in a bit.
I always mess up the beginning part. I always mess up the end. That's why I'm kind of laughing. Every time I mess up, I laugh. It is 20 hours and 58 minutes into the day of Tuesday, June 14th, 2016. And this is another segment of Big Bang Theory's BTS log. At some point in time, when these are other things, I gotta get in the habit of using the opening segment, the opening bit there, because I'm gonna use it to tag videos for that I film on here for other shows, and so the clips don't get mixed up. I need to know in the beginning what clip this is, and so the opening segment tells me what it is. It tells me when it was shot, the date and time. And that way I can put things into sequential order into its proper place. But because this is a raw vlog, nothing's edited, nothing's taken out, you see everything. In the shows, when I'm doing Insta vlogs, other shows that are more polished, that will have graphics in it, you will not see that part. That part will be cut out. So you'll see everything from the raw to the final cut, in some form or another. So this is the raw form right here. This is the raw film clip or video clip, and it shows the progress that I make and the pace I make progress. I'm pretty slow at things. I'm not the fastest person. It's not easy for me to get up and do these things. I do have to work at it again and again and again. My thing is that I don't know when to quit. I keep going even though I keep failing. I mean, as long as I have some degree of success, then I'm happy. So even if it's a tiny little bit of success. But anyways, we're Thursday will be current again. Yeah. So this is today is the 14th. By the 16th of June, we'll be current again. The vlogs will be current again, and the backlog would have been cleared off. I mean, right now, June 8th went up today, and in a little while, June 10th to 11th, tomorrow, that will go up. So we'll have a vlog for that as well. So we are getting caught up. I'm finding ways of sort of getting the work done and sort of getting the information done that I need to get done. So it's not specifically the end of the day. Even though it's about 9 o'clock in the evening, it's not specifically the end of the day. My day seems to be shifting again. So we'll see what happens. I'm just watching some IPTV and having a drink. I moved the next episode, it's off the editing bay now and into the system where I do a lot of the description. I do the sort of the descriptive write-up, I do the titling and everything like that. And then once that's done, it goes over to a new system in the front room that handles a lot of the uploading. It's better for uploading. So I've done that. And I think between tonight and tomorrow, I'll finish the cleaning work in the kitchen and in the front room so I can get the new editing bay over there functional. So that's the next set. That'll take care of a lot of the backlog. It seems to be like this year, particularly, like a lot of things have gone wrong. There's been a lot of repairs I've had to do. I have to repair a lighting system in the kitchen now, the kitchen diner. That light is gone out on me. And so I do have a way of repairing it. It's just a matter, it's going to take me some time to get in there and get all the work done. The issue is, again, scheduling. It's a scheduling issue. How do you schedule all the work that needs to get done? And if you look at my place, that place is kind of cluttered, isn't it? Yeah. Well, when you're working 12-hour days, when you're doing 12 hours of studying, and you need to push that research forward. And a lot of times when you are doing that research, your mind isn't on anything else. Your mind is specifically on the studying. It's like anyone who's gone through exams knows this. That time is very tight and your focus is very narrow. You're focused on those exams. And it's hard to get anything else done. This is sort of the situation here. A lot of times it's exam time here. I have sparse time in between the exam times in terms of the way the day goes to get other things done. What I've been doing now is I've been learning how to sort of spread out my time, do a better job at time management. It sounds funny that, I'm talking about time management. I got stuffed animals behind me. I said I'm a big kid, but I realized that if I do a better job at time management, what will end up happening, I'll have more time to sort of more free time, because time management is about how efficient you are at doing your work and getting all the work done that needs to get done. That way, things don't get backlogged as much. You can clear backlogs easier. And dealing with large messes or problems aren't as problem because you're breaking them up. As I said, you break up the project, the big project, into smaller sub-projects that can be done in 5-10 minute chunks. And if you do it like that, then it's not as complex, and you'll actually be surprised. You think, oh, why? You know, the 5-10 minute chunks, that's not a lot. You can actually get a lot done within 5-10 minutes. You know, you're going to the bathroom, you're going to a particular area that needs to be cleaned up. Do one or two little small projects while you're there, and then come back and do something else that needs to be done here. You know, just do, you know, if they're small projects, bit by bit throughout the day as you go back and forth between these different places, things actually get done. It's the accumulative effect. Pronunciation and enunciation. Pronunciation is an issue here. Pronouncing words sometimes is a challenge, even though I don't always intend it to be. I've noticed how I run over words. I'm not clear sometimes when I speak. I mean, again, this is what the BTS vlog is for. It's partially from a practice. It's partially for a variety of different things. And in addition to providing for other people, I was talking to some of my friends who are watching the vlog. I said, well, why do you keep your vlog the way you do? Well, is it the scientific journaling is raw and uncut. There's no editing in it. But the second thing is when I talk about my fatigue and you see the fatigue issues here, there's a lot of work being done in sleep research. There's a lot of money being spent on sleep research. And I'm leaving my videos, my vlog, out there for other researchers who want to use my vlogs, who want to use me as an example of sort of observation of how sleep deprivation actually affects a person. And how you overcome it or how you deal with it. I mean, I talk about the physiology. I talk about the way I'm doing the organic chemistry within my own body. You can see the effects. You can see, you know, is something successful? Is something not successful? How long does the effect last? How long doesn't it last? You know, does it wear off? Does it change? You know, is there something that looks like it's working well, but then ends up being a placebo effect because once the enthusiasm wears off, are you back to a situation that was there prior, or is it maybe that your body's chemistry is changing? You have a change in the biochemistry in the body. Now you're not going to have a lot of change in the biochemistry, but you can have enough that when you introduce something new to the system, it has a positive effect or an effect anyways, and then afterwards that effect sort of disappears because the body has adjusted to the new system. It's become routine, and the effect isn't as pronounced as it was when you first started. So this is a record of all this. And the thing is, when it's not cut out, when it is a scientific record, a scientific journal, you can say, okay, nothing's been censored here, and this is your raw work, this is the raw footage. And then you can go ahead and edit and sort of adjust things for whatever purposes you need to. Anyway, and there's the part there too, right? The thought patterns. We represents the I'm thinking about how to say something, or I'm thinking about what the next line, what the next thought should be. Okay? And it's sort of there's a gap in between the statement and the mind's positioning. So the position where your mind is, what your mind is thinking about, what your mind is talking about, is different from what you have in the mouth, from the physical representation. And if there's a gap, that's when the tends to come in. But if you're conscious of it, you're aware of it, and I'm doing this now, then it doesn't seem to have that much of an effect. I'm able to catch it and then sort of deal with it in that form or in that manner. Anyways, I'm going to leave this here for now. And this is probably going to be the last clip for this episode. So I will see you in the next episode for Big Bang Theory's BTS vlog. All right, so I'll see you then.
I am the professor. And professor of what? Professor of physics.
Oh, say, can you see?
Speech rules here at Democratic Earth.